Today's experiment involves extremely high temperatures and a risk of fire. I always make extremely smart choices when I do science at home, and you should too when you do science at home. Thanks. Hey everyone, Eric here, the director of exhibits for Curiodyssey, and we're back in the workshop. And today I have a question for you. What would you say if I said, I'm gonna set this piece of steel on fire? Is that even possible? Well, today we are going to take a look at burning metal. That's right. We're going to focus on steel today because there are combustible metals out there that some of you are probably aware of. But steel is a particularly interesting challenge, and it's a pathway to some really interesting chemistry. So we're going to take a look at that momentarily. But I have to remind you, if you like this video, please help us keep creating ways to experience Curiodyssey from home with a donation today at curiodyssey.org. Thanks very much. Let's gather up some supplies, get our safety equipment together, and go head over to the work table and see if we can actually burn steel. Okay, so we're all set up. Before we take a look at the supplies, let's have just a quick word again about safety, because we are working with some high temperatures here, combustion, and so there's a risk of fire or injury. So I just want to cover that. We've got safety glasses, very important. These have metal screen side shields to protect from sparks or any flying debris. We've got a fire extinguisher, of course, always good to have right nearby when you're doing any experiment with fire. And then I've clad my workbench with metal so that it can be protected against any sparks or flames that might come in contact with it. I also have a safety shield for the camera. So we're protecting ourselves, we're protecting our property. So what do we need to burn through some metal? Well, obviously we need metal and we need fire. So let's take a look at some of the options there, because there's some variables that we can adjust. Okay, so let's take a look at some of our options here, because you might just be saying, well, you need a really hot flame to burn through a piece of steel, and that is true. So here's a couple options that are sort of typical hardware store type items. This is a blowtorch connected to a tank of propane, and propane burns at about 3600, a little less than 3600 degrees Fahrenheit. And then we have map gas in this yellow canister that burns at a little bit over 3,700 degrees Fahrenheit, so this might be better, right? Well, the truth is, for a lot of pieces of steel, that's just not good enough. So what do people do? Well, often they'll mix oxygen with the fuel. That boosts the temperature of the flame. In fact, it's pretty common to use oxygen and acetylene to burn through steel, and it's commonly done as an industrial process, cutting steel with a oxygen-acetylene torch. So that's an option, but there's another variable here, and I want to bring it up because what if I wanted to burn through steel with this? There we go. This is just a regular barbecue lighter. Basically, something you'd light your birthday candles with. So is it possible to burn through steel with something like this? Well, the other variable will be the mass of the metal itself. So while you could take the lighter and hold it under this piece of steel, I don't think you'd get very far. But what if we were working with this? This, of course, is steel wool. It's essentially fine steel wires arranged in this kind of fluffy mass. So the mass of the metal makes a big difference. So let's go ahead and set this up and put a flame to this, and let's see what happens. All right, so here we go. This is burning steel in 3, 2, 1. Whoa, look at it go. That is wild. See how the combustion follows along the lengths of the wires. It travels through the wires. Just a little bit still going. Oh, and it's out.
That was awesome.
All right. Put itself out. Let's see if there's still some combustion that can be had if I can relight it. So here we go, relighting in 3, 2, 1.
Not as easy to relight that time. Interesting. Now there is a fascinating chemical change that occurs with this. And I'm just putting that out there as a tease, because I think I'm going to talk about that in a later video.
Okay, so there you have it. Burning steel. It's possible even with a simple lighter. I mean, that's pretty amazing. And it was really interesting to see how the combustion travels along those little steel wires. But this has me wondering, is there another way to ignite this steel? Maybe a way that doesn't involve flame at all? Interesting. Well, I have one more possible method for us to try out, and I have to say, I have never tried this. I've seen it done, but I have not done it myself, so let's head back over to the work table and give version 2 of Burning Through Steel a test.
Okay, so we are resetting. I've got a new piece of steel wool that I have fluffed up to get a lot of airspace in it. And now we need our combustion source. So as I mentioned, how can we do this without an open flame? But would you believe it is possible to create an electrical arc that is hot enough to set that steel on fire with this 9-volt battery? That's right. So let's give that a try next. Here's setting fire to steel wool with 9-volt battery in 3, 2, 1. Look at it go!
That was really amazing. I have to say, I've never done that in person, and so seeing it with your own eyes is pretty neat. So what's happening there? Well, the 9-volt battery, when you touch it to the steel wires, it actually creates a short circuit. It's enough to generate enough heat to actually set the steel wires alight. That heat that's generated from the combusting wire is enough to light adjacent wires in the mass on fire as well, and so the reaction spreads. And it's pretty fascinating. You can set steel wool on fire with just a little 9-volt battery. So, pretty interesting. Now, as I teased, there is a fascinating chemical reaction happening when that steel burns. And there's some interesting things to learn about that. So, we're going to talk about that in another video in the future. So that's something to look forward to, but I have to say, if you like this video, please help us keep creating ways to enjoy Curiodyssey from home with a donation today at curiodyssey.org. Thanks again. I hope you had as much fun as I did, and we'll see you again next time.